This is Catherine Schmer at Chattanooga State Community College. This is video one on the topic of functions of two variables. In this video, we will look at functions that have two input variables, x and y, with a z variable as the output. We will discuss domain and range of these functions, as well as some properties of the domain region. A function of two variables is a rule that assigns a number to each ordered pair x, y in its domain. For example, we will look at the function z equals f of x, y equals the square root of x squared plus y squared minus 4. First, we are asked to find and sketch the domain of f of x, y. Remember from algebra that the domain of a function refers to all possible input variables, or all x, y ordered pairs that result in a real number z value output. We'll be asked to sketch the domain, so I will need an x, y grid. Now let's look at the type of function that we're dealing with. We have a square root function. Since the value inside a square root must be greater than or equal to 0, we have x squared plus y squared minus 4 is greater than or equal to 0. Get this into a form that we can recognize, and we have that the domain is all xy in R2 such that x squared plus y squared is greater than or equal to 4. We can write this using set notation, the curvy brackets. So we have bracket xy in R2. The curved E symbol means is an element of, or in, such that, the vertical bar, x squared plus y squared is greater than or equal to 4. Let's label the axes. We know that x squared plus y squared equals 4 is a circle of radius 2, so I will start by graphing that. Since we have x squared plus y squared is greater than or equal to 4, that gives us all circles of radius 2 or greater, so we will shade all points outside of the radius 2 circle. And that's the domain, all points on and outside the circle of radius 2. Now we want to find the range of f of xy. We know that the range is all possible output values of a function, in this case, all possible z values that the function could produce. The function given to us is z equals the square root of x squared plus y squared minus 4. Now let's consider the type of function. We know that a square root function will always result in a non-negative output, in this case, non-negative z values. So the range of this function is z is greater than or equal to 0. Next, we're going to talk about different properties that the domain might have. We'll start with the boundary of the domain. A boundary point of a region R may or may not belong to the region. A point x0, y0 is a boundary point of R if every disk centered at x0, y0 contains points both inside and outside of R. The boundary of a region R is the set of all boundary points. we want to find the boundary of the function's domain. Remember from part one that the domain of our given function is all points on or outside of the circle of radius 2. Let's look at a point on the circle of radius 2. If we draw a small disk around that point, the disk will contain points both inside and outside of the domain. This is a boundary point, since any disk around the point contains points both inside of and outside of the shaded region. Using this definition, every point on the circle is a boundary point. So the boundary is x squared plus y squared equals 4. The next property that we'll discuss is whether a domain region is closed or open. A region is closed if it contains all of its boundary points. It is open if it contains no boundary points. So, is the domain of our given function an open region, a closed region, or neither? Keep in mind that it would only be neither if it contained some but not all of the boundary points. In our case, the domain is x squared plus y squared greater than or equal to 4, which is all points on or outside of the circle of radius 2. Because of the equality bar, the domain includes the boundary circle x squared plus y squared equals 4, so the domain is closed. The last property that we discuss in this video is whether a domain region is bounded or unbounded. A region in the plane is bounded if it lies inside a disk of fixed radius. A region is unbounded if it is not bounded. So, is our domain bounded or unbounded? Well, looking at the graph of the domain, we can see that the domain expands infinitely since it is the outside of the circle of radius 2. So it is unbounded, meaning that it cannot be contained. So as a brief recap, we looked at domain and range of a function of two variables. Then we determined the boundary of the domain and whether the domain was closed or open and bounded or unbounded. The definitions in this section are ones that you will need to memorize or understand intuitively.